and dot components of the signal. So the signal is given as x of t is equal to the, so it is 2 minus t for 0 is less than t is less than equal to the 2 and 0 otherwise. Okay. So this is a question has been given. For this one, we need to find out the even and the odd component here. Okay. So here the expression x of t is given in terms of 2 minus t from 0 to the 2 and 0 otherwise here. So whether we need to check out whether it is possible to find the even component of the signal like itself only. Okay, if it is possible to find like the itself here, we can find out here. Or whichever is a better way, we can go for that one here. Okay. So for this one, the better method is let us go for the graphical method here. Graphical method. So let us plot the waveform for this one. Okay, since it is given 2 minus t from 0 to the 2. 2 minus t from 0 to 2. Let us substitute the lower limit and the upper limit and get the mathematical corresponding value here. So when t is equal to 0, so this has become x of 0. So it is nothing but 2 minus 0 will be equal to the 2 will get here. Next, when t is equal to, if you want, you can substitute the upper limit 2. So it will become x of 2 is equal to the, so 2 minus 2 will be the 0 here. So let us plot the waveform. The waveform will be like this. At t is equal to 0, it is 2. At t is equal to 2, it will be 0. So let us mark it here. Let us mark the waveform. So this value will be 1. So this is 1 here. So this is the waveform called x of t here. Okay. So this is a waveform called x of t. Let us plot that one. And for getting the even component or the odd component, we need to find out the x of minus t. Okay. X of minus t, let us find out here. Let us take the time reflection for that one. So when you take the time reflection, this will become minus 2 to 0, the value will be 2. This will become x of minus t here. X of minus t. Okay, so let us find out the even component from this one. Let us find out the even component from this formula. Okay, so at t is equal to 0, we have 2. At t is equal to 0, this is 2 is there here. So 2 by 2 will become equal to the 1 will get here because this is for t is greater than 0 here. You can see. This is for t is greater than 0. This is for t is less than 0 here. Okay. So t is greater than 0 and t is less than 0. At t exactly equal to 0, it is 0. At t exactly equal to 0, it will be 0 will be there here. So don't get confused. So 2 plus 2 will be the 4. 4 by 2 will be the 2 will get like this. Okay. Correct now? So this is for t is exactly 0. It is 0. T exactly 0. It will be 0 will be there here. So when you're going to add the waveform here, when you're going to add this waveform, so what we'll get is, from this side it is 2, from this side it will be 2. So the waveform will be like this, will get here. So from minus 2 to the plus 2. So this is 2 will get here because this side positive side it is 2, it negative side it is 2 here. Okay, when you take the half of this one, so it will become, so 2 by 2, the amplitude will become equal to the 1 will get here as per this formula. 1 will get here. So don't get confused with respect to this one. So this is the even component here. This is the even component. When you take the difference of this one, that is x of t. So this has become x of t minus x of minus t divided by 2. When you take the difference of these two, okay, so this will be the positive axis you'll get here. This minus this one. So this will be the negative waveform you'll get like this here. Negative waveform. So this is the x of t. So since the 2 by 1 will be the 2 minus 1. So this is minus 2 plus 2 will get here. Okay, so this is the even component and odd component of the signal x of t will get here. Done, right? So this is for t is greater than 0, this is for t is less than 0. When you are going to add, the waveform will be like this, will get here. Any doubts? Okay, so one more problem it is being given, the fourth B problem. So the problem is x of n, right? X of n is equal to the 2 to the power of, what is the problem? Can you tell me any, can you tell me the problem?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
X of n equals to?
Yeah.
Alpha power n.
Okay, alpha to the power of n.
U of n minus 3.
Okay.
Where the limits are 0 lesser than alpha lesser than 1.
0 is less than alpha is less than 1. Means alpha is the value which is going to take less than that one it will take here. Okay. So thank you. Yeah. So x of n is equal to alpha to the power of n into u of n minus 3 for 0 is less than alpha is less than 1 here. Means it is the exponentially decaying signal here, because alpha can take the value less than 1, so it will be decaying here. So when ua is u of n minus 3, means when n is u of n minus 3, you know that. So it is equal to 1. What are the things? N minus 3 is greater than or equal to 0, or for n is greater than or equal to the 3 here, greater than or equal to 3. So this will be the value will be there. So we can have the waveform. Let us, if you want, you can plot the waveform here from 3 onwards here. So this is 3. So this will become equal to the alpha to the power of 3 will get here. Means it is since the alpha can take the value less than 1 only, not equal to 1, the waveform will be in the decreasing format you are going to get here, decreasing format here. Okay. So like this, the waveform will be decreasing like this will get here. So this is x of n will get here. So u of n minus 3 is, it is having the value 1 from 3 to the infinity will be there. So 3 to the infinity, since it is scaled by the factor alpha to the power of n, since alpha can take the value less than 1, okay, so it will be exponential decaying signal will get here, decaying signal. Okay, the waveform will be like this. So it will be decaying like this here. So this is n. Okay, so we can do this one mathematically, we can do it here, or if you want, you can do it waveform graphical format also, you can do it here, not an issue. Okay, so done. Okay, fine. So I think everyone has taken the waveform. So now alpha to the power of n into u of n minus 3 is I. When I take the reflection, so x of n is equal to alpha to the power of into u of n minus 3 is there. So this is having the value. We know that u of n minus 3, it is equal to 1 for 3 is less than n, is less than the infinity, and 0 otherwise. Okay, na? 0 otherwise. So we can write this one as x of n is equal to, we can substitute the value of u of n as, so it is alpha to the power of n into multiply by 1. From 3 is less than n, is less than the infinity, and 0 otherwise here. Can we write like this? For the u of n minus 3, the value is 1 here. This is x of n here. Now we need to take the x of minus n here. X of minus n means the reflection will be there. Reflection is the thing, but what are the positives will be there? It will go to the negative axis here. So this will become equal to the, this will become equal to the, so alpha to the power of minus n. So n can take the value. Okay, negative side it will take here, alpha to the power of minus n. So from minus 3, sorry, minus infinity is less than n, is less than 3 will get here. Minus infinity is less than 3, is less than n will get here. Okay, so got it now? Done, right? Done?
Yes, sir.
So now you can add the signals, you can find the even and odd components here. So let us find the even and odd components here. Do it first. So even component is, when you're going to add this one, it will become the even component. And odd component is, when you're going to take the difference, it will become the odd component. So you can find out that one. So u1 component you can find as x of n plus x of minus n divided by 2, and similarly the odd component x of n minus x of minus n divided by 2. So this will become equal to the, when you're going to add this one, so this is from 3 to the infinity, this is from minus infinity to this is minus 3 here, not plus 3. So minus infinity to the minus 3 will be there, minus infinity to the minus 3. So we can say x of n is equal to the even component will become equal to the, so it is alpha to the power of n, okay, alpha to the power of n divided by 2, since it will be scaled by the factor 2 here. So from 3 is less than n, is less than infinity, okay, so 3 is less than n, is less than infinity, and this will be alpha to the power of minus n divided by 2, okay, alpha to the power of minus n divided by 2. So from minus infinity is less than n, is less than or equal to the minus 3 here. Okay, so because since the different limits are there, we need to keep in the different formats like this only. We need to combine these two here. Okay, and 0 otherwise you can put here 0 otherwise. So similarly for the odd component, so this is the even component. So similarly for the odd component, we can write, so this is alpha to the power of n by 2. So from 3 is less than equal to n, less than infinity, and minus alpha to the power of minus n by 2. So from minus infinity is less than n, is less than or equal to the minus 3, and 0 otherwise here. 0 otherwise. Done, right? Okay, so you can do like this here. So done. Any doubts? Any doubts in this one? Similar way, you can do the sum of products. It has been given something called alpha to the power of n into u of n is given. So you can similar way, you can do the find the even and odd component like that. You can find out here. Okay. So done, right?
Yes, sir.
That is one problem I have given, alpha to the power of n into u of n. Same way you can do it here. Okay. So under some more problems are given in the assignment. So that is something called 8 into 0.5 to the power of n into u of n. That also you can do in the similar fashion, you can do it here. Okay. So when n can take the negative value, it will become minus n here. So like that you can do it here. Done. Any doubts in the assignment questions? Any doubts in the assignment questions?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Can you send the module to notes, sir?
Yeah, today I'll after the class I'll send this one because I thought of solving some more problems here. So after the class I'll send. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So any doubts in the assignment questions? So what are the problems I did in the class? So see those questions. Okay. Don't stick on to the assignment. So what I have solved, that will get here. Okay, so fine. In the last class, I given this as homework. Done, anyone? Anyone has done? Okay, so yesterday, how many of you attended the GATE seminar? So I have seen hardly some few names from your class. Okay. So whenever the things you are getting free of cost, try to utilize that one. Okay, so whether it will be interesting, whether it will be not interesting, you will come to know once you attend that particular thing here. Okay, so by looking at the title, we can't able to identify whether the speaker will be interesting or not. Once you attend the seminar or some any other class, we'll come to know how much interesting will be there, what are the important facts are there here. Okay, so some of the snaps I shared to your group. Okay. Even though repeatedly all the faculties are telling to join, but I have seen only few names from your class. Okay, so because you will be not knowing after completing your 4 years. Okay, so after spending 4 years of span of time, the precious time, you will be having enough free time, will be there, no responsibility for you. Okay, so in this time when you don't have any responsibility, there will be no tension here. You have only responsibility, study, learn, get the concept, get the knowledge here. Okay, so for the GATE, if you start preparing from now itself, if you start preparing here, so at the time of attending the GATE exam, so it will be very easy for you. And even you can score better good marks in the semester exam also, you can score here. Okay, as I told, suppose if you want to go for higher studies, M.Tech, okay, if you qualify the GATE exam, you can able to get the stipend of 25,000 per month here. Okay, it is equal to the salary those who are getting. Okay, so think of that one, which are the things we are going to tell. So just you can listen to our words, because I think I am a bit aged person when compared to you people. I'm having a bit experience when compared to you people. I have seen many batches of the students. So with my vast experience, I am telling what are the things you're supposed to do for your future, for your better future. ಓಕೆ ನಾ ಸೊ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರೋ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಇದೆ ಅನ್ಕೊಂತೀನಿ. ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಯಾ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅವರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಸೇಕ್. ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಉದ್ದಾರ, ನೀವು ಒಳ್ಳೇದಾಗಲಿ, ನೀವು ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರಲಿ, ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕಲೀಲಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೀವಿ ಅಷ್ಟು, ಅಥವಾ ನೀವು ಹಾಳಾಗೋಗ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ ಯಾರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಡೂ ದ ಸಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಯು ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಅಟೆಂಡ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್. ಸೊ ಫೈನ್. So in the last class, I given the problem y of n is equal to 2 into x of n into u of n here. Okay. So if you want, you can install that app here. That is the Ohm Institute. So you can go to the Play Store. You can search Ohm Institute. Okay, so that you'll get the app, so that you'll get the free videos you'll get here. So you can come to know how the things will be there. So right, fine. So y of n is equal to 2 into x of n into u of n. So this is the problem I have given here. We need to verify the linearity property. So to verify the linearity property, so as usual, you tell me. Any doubts? So let x of n is equal to the a1 into x1 of n plus a2 into x of n. You can give it here. So you can do the linearity property. I think it's not difficult here. So done. What is the linearity property? What do you want me to do? So that is y of n will become 2 into a1 into x1 of n plus a2 into x2 of n. So multiply by the u of n. So this has become 2 into a1 into x1 of n into u of n plus 2 into a2 into x2 of n into u of n will get here. So say this is nothing but y of n l, cause this is equation number 1 here. Now give the individual input here. So I'm going to give the individual input as h of a1 into x1 of n as the input I'm giving here. The output will be y1, let us call here. So this will be multiplied by the output, the system operator h is nothing but. Okay, so it is 2 into u of n. So it is going to multiply the output with the 2 into u of n, multiply with the whatever the input you are going to give here. So similarly, I'm going to give h of a2 of x2 of n. So y2 of n is equal to, so 2 into u of n into a2 of x2 of n will get here. Okay, so say that y3 of n is equal to y1 of n plus y2 of n. So this has become a1 into 2 into a1 into x1 of n into u of n plus 2 into a2 of n into x2 of n into u of n. So call this equation number 2 here. Call this as equation number 2. So compare the equation 2 and 1. So compare 1 and 2. So if you compare the 1 and 2, so y of n is equal to y1 of y3 of n. So therefore, it is a linear system here. The system is a linear system. The given system is a linear system here. Done, right? This is the first property, linearity. The second one is stability. Stability. So done, everyone. So y of n is equal to 2 into x of n into u of n. So let us consider the magnitude of this one. Whenever we consider the magnitude, it will become less than or equal to the. So magnitude of 2 into x of n into u of n. Okay, so y of n, the magnitude will become, so 2 into, so the magnitude of 2 is 2 only. So x of n magnitude into u of n magnitude. Okay, so we can say x of n is less than or equal to, the magnitude of x of n is less than or equal to the mx here. Okay, is less than the infinity. So means that, so y of n, the x of n can take the maximum value. So this is for the all the values of n here. So the this mx I'm going to substitute here. So you can do like this also, no problem. Mx into u of n here. Mx into u of n. Okay. So since the u of n for the particular value of n, it is equal to 1 here. So the output y of n is also bounded here. The output y of n is also bounded here. Therefore, this will be less than infinity. This will be less than infinity. You can take like this also, no problem. This is also correct here. Mx into u of n less than infinity. Okay, so just I am telling what I am doing is I am substituting the value of mx here. That's it, here nothing else I am doing. So this value, since the input is bounded, the output is also going to be bounded here. So right, so what we can say here, so then I think everyone has taken. Okay, so then we can say the output, so then y of n, the magnitude of y of n is less than or equal to the my, is less than the infinity. Therefore, it is a stable system here. Stable system. So since the input is finite, the output is also going to be the finite you are going to get here. Done. next let us go for the checking the memory R. So y of n is equal to, let us take the given system, 2 into x of n into u of n. Okay, done. So in order to verify the memory, let us substitute n is equal to 0. Let us see, the present output depends on the present value of the input or past values of the input here. So you can say, sorry, n is equal to 0. So it has become x of 0 into y of u of 0. So for the present value of the output depends on the present input here. Let us check for one more value. So y of n is equal to, so 2 into x of 1 into u of 1, u of 1 here. Okay, done. Like that, we can check the memory property. So since the present value of the input output depends on the present value of the input only, so the given system is a memoryless system here. So you can write, since the present output, depends on the present input only, therefore it is a memoryless system here. It is a memoryless system. It doesn't have any memory. Memoryless system here. So what are the property you're going to get? You highlight the property. Done. So the next property is nothing but causality. So whenever the simple problems are there, you can do like this only. But only thing, the big problem what everyone is having, interest. Concentration. So everyone is having the same problem. If you are interested, so we can do easily any big task. We can do it easily. We can do it here. So causality. So causality. It is also same from the previous. Only we got the output here. So since the present output does not run the future values of the input here, the system is a a causal system here. So you can take, since the present output. The present output does not depend on the future values of the input. Therefore, the system is a causal system here. So right. Then causal system. So next one is the property which is called as the time invariance property. So time invariance, how to obtain is, so you're going to replace the x of n by, so replace x of n by x of n minus n naught here, x of n minus n naught, so that we are going to get y of n is equal to 2 into x of n minus n naught into u of n will get here, 2 into x of n minus n naught into u of n. So similarly, let us replace n by n minus n naught in y of n here. Let us call this as a y1 of n here. So you replace n by n minus n naught in the y of n, so that it will become, so y of n minus n naught is equal to the 2 into x of n minus n naught into u of n minus n naught here. Okay, so let us call this as equation number 3 and call this as equation number 4. So compare equation 3 and 4. Therefore, 3 and 4 both are not the same here. So we come to know, whenever the n term, extra n term is there, the system will be, it's not a time invariant system here. So it is not a time invariant system here. Okay, so done, right? The given system is not a time invariant system. So all the things are easy here. So whichever problems are given as homework, the easy problems will be giving here. So if I'm keep on solving the easy problems again and again, so it will be much time consuming. I can't able to solve the, okay. So the complex problems I can't able to solve. So right. Done, right. Done.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so like this, you can solve the problem easily. Which are the easy problems you can solve like this here? So, okay, which are the easy properties are there? I'll leave that one. So, which are the complicated ones is there? I'll do that as that problem I'll do in the class here. So the remaining concepts, easy one, you can do it here. Okay, so that I can do more problems, I can do it here. And I will cover the variety of problems I can cover here. So otherwise, then simply I'll be keep on solving the easy problems. Okay, so that will be much time consuming. So okay, so take the next problem. Y of t is equal to the e to the power of x of t. Y of t is equal to the e to the power of x of t. So some complicated problems will be there, so I need to solve that one. So when I given as a homework here, so I try to solve that one. So let us verify the linearity property. So I'll be having the time constraint. So within the time constraint, I need to finish the syllabus also. Okay. So to keep to try to practice the problems. So let us do with the linearity property. So as usual, the linearity properties, what we need to do is let us substitute x of t is equal to the, so a1 into x1 of t plus a2 into x2 of t. So the y of t has become e to the power of a1 into x1 of t plus a2 into x2 of t. Okay. A1 into x1 of t plus a2 into x2 of t. So let us apply that one. So we know from the law of indices, you know, e to the power of a plus b. So this we can write as the e to the power of a into e to the power of b, you can write here. Correct now? So let us split this one. So it is a1 into x1 of t. So into e to the power of a2 into x2 of t will get here. So call this as equation number one here. Done? Done, right? Okay, so this we got here. Now what we do is, let us give the individual input, let us give here. So h of a1 into x1 of t, let us give here. H of a1 of x1 of t, let us give as the input here. So the output will be, so what we'll be getting is, so e to the power of a1 into x1 of t will be getting here. So we'll call this as the y1 of t here. Call this as the y1 of t. So similarly, give the other input here. So give that one. So what time up to class here? The class up to 12:50, right?
Yes, sir, up to 12:50.
Oh, sir, but Avinash sir has sent some link regarding IA.
So keep doing this one. Solve this problem. Hello. Okay, so you can solve this problem and you can join that session by 12:30. So another 2 minutes I'll take here. Now it's 12:26, 2 minutes I'll take here. Okay, so a1 into x1 of t, the output will be, okay, this is y1 of t will get here. So similarly, h of a2 into x2 of t, okay, this will become e into a2 into x2 of t will get. So call this as the y2 of t here. So right, so now, let us say y3 of t is equal to the sum of this one. So it is y1 of t plus y2 of t. So this will become e into a1 into x1 of t plus a into a2 of x2 of t here. So call this as equation number 2. Compare equation 1 and 2 here. So compare equation 1 and 2. So okay. So the it is not okay, if I have any other problems,